Flashing the BIOS or updating your BIOS is one of the most important things you can do for your PC. It literally opens up the world to brand new CPUs, brand new sticks of RAM, brand new SSDs, and then closes up a ton of security holes that they find over time. You can't build a perfect BIOS on your first shot. Maybe your board came out a year ago and they just released a new processor, but that processor doesn't work until you update your BIOS. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I update my BIOS, how I find my BIOS, how I find the support site for my BIOS, how I download the BIOS, how to prepare a thumb drive for my BIOS, then finally how to flash the BIOS, and some basics on how to configure your BIOS. Without wasting any more time, let's get started. I just put my system together, or maybe I want to buy a brand new processor, so I need to find out if my board supports it, or maybe a graphics card or an SSD. First off, in a browser, and it could be on this very PC or another PC, I'll open up a browser, then I'll go to the support site. I don't know it off the top of my head, so I'm going to type in the manufacturer and then the model number of my motherboard. And then typically it'll be one of the first or the exact first. Okay, this is the support site for my motherboard. It tells me everything about my motherboard. Yours, of course, might be different. So then I'll click on support. Then here under support, I'll go to drivers and downloads, and I'll look for firmware and BIOS. I'll scroll down a tiny bit. And then here are all of our BIOSes. So for example, if this is a brand new board, and let's say it came with this BIOS, or maybe this BIOS here, 1.1. Cool, it has adjust support. But then if, as we scroll up, we see they added DDR5 memory capacity. They fixed STAPM issues with the Ryzen 8000 series, a newer series of processor. Some more adjusta updates, optimization for memory training, and fixing some DMI problems. Keep going up, improved NVIDIA graphics card compatibility, optimized boot time, optimized memory, optimized curve optimizer, fixed a security issue, added TPM 105 watts, improved CCD delay, performance optimizations for the brand new AMD Ryzen 9800 X3D. So all of those fixes and features, but how do I know what BIOS I'm on? So for that, we'll open up HW Info, and I'll have a link down below where you can find it, and I'll click start. Close this out. Now here is your motherboard right at the very front, and we can see here the model number and everything that I selected. The BIOS date is 9/27/24. It's version 1.80. So if we come back over here, 1.8 and 9.30. So I'm pretty current, but maybe I just bought this processor and I need it to work. So I'm just going to go ahead and click download here. Okay, so that's a quick download. It comes inside of a zip file. So what's a zip file? A zip file is an archive, maybe of 100 files or maybe of one file, compressed to make it a lot smaller to make it easier to travel. So the BIOS is inside of that zip file. Now we can't flash from the zip file. We need to pull that out. I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm also going to show you how I prepare a thumb drive for flashing. So first off, I plug it into the front of my machine or the back. And when that pops up, we'll find our thumb drive. It could be whatever drive letter. And I just want to make sure there's nothing in here. I have all this backed up. I'm studying for my Network Plus now. But regardless, now I don't care what's on this thumb drive, so I'm going to erase it. We need to delete all of the files from that thumb drive. So just make sure if it's something you need, copy it somewhere else for now. So we right click on that thumb drive and we'll click format. Now it has to be file system FAT32. All the BIOSes read that. And then you can name it whatever you'd like here. I'll call it BIOS. And make sure you have quick format on. Depending how large your thumb drive is, it could take a long time to wipe it. Quick format will make it really quick. So we'll click start. And it is complete. We can open up and see there's nothing in there. If we go to our downloads folder, we'll find the 716 version 191 BIOS file. You can't easily tell, but that's a compressed file. We can't use that. It also say it right over here. But aside from the icon, how can you tell? Well, if you don't have file extensions shown, you can't. So what I recommend to do is within File Explorer, you click View, and then you click Show. You want to make sure that file name extensions is checked. And then also I like to show hidden items as well. I'll click that there. So now we can see that file name .zip. That tells us it's a compressed file. The BIOS won't read the compressed file. So we double click on it and then we find this folder. And it's okay if we grab this folder, but it's best for a BIOS file if you go back inside that folder, and we can grab both of these. And then we copy them and we go to our BIOS thumb drive and we paste them in there. Now, it's okay that there's two files there, but the main one you want is the BIOS file here, which could be .whatever, and is typically a ROM or a bin, but this is just so that they can show you the version number. And then over here, the text file tells you what gets corrected inside of this BIOS file. So that's good information to have. So now this thumb drive has been 100% prepared. All we needed to do was format it as FAT32 and then copy our BIOS file onto the thumb drive. Just remember, we took the BIOS outside of the zip file and placed it at the root of the thumb drive. So now let's flash it real quick. Now that we're good here, we're going to go into the BIOS. So to do that, we'll just close out of everything here. Then we'll close out of here. We don't need this anymore. And then we simply right click on our start button, shut down our sign out, and then click restart. Now, depending on what kind of motherboard you have or what kind of system you have, the button to get into the BIOS is going to be different. For me, the button is the delete key. So I just start tapping the delete key every 2 seconds. All right, now we're in the BIOS. Now this is the place where we flash the BIOS to update it to the latest version. You may want to come in here, take a few notes, and just write down all of your settings. You want to make sure that after you flash the BIOS, you can come in here and enable anything that needs to be enabled and disable anything that needs to be disabled as well. When you flash the BIOS, it erases your BIOS and then applies a brand new BIOS. Don't worry, none of the data on your hard drive or your SSD is going to get erased. Just your BIOS is going to get updated. We'll come over here. For an MSI board, it's mFlash, but it could be different on your motherboard. We'll find the utility to flash the BIOS. mFlash. System will auto reboot and enter flash mode. Do you want to enter flash mode? Yes. Okay, so now that we're in the flash mode, here we can see we're at version 1.8. We'll select this flash right over here. After we select it, it tells us the version of the BIOS we're going to, 1.91, but we already knew that. So we'll just click here again. Then are you sure you selected this file? Yeah, again, it's outside of the zip file. So it's E7E16AMS.191. And we'll select yes. This is going to take a few minutes. And don't worry, during this process, your system will restart a few times. It's completely normal. Don't worry, there are no issues. Like I mentioned, the system just finished and it restarted. Now it may restart once or twice more, and then we need to go inside of the BIOS to configure everything. Now we're back inside of the BIOS. We can see right up here, we're on BIOS version 191. That is awesome. One thing we want to do before we set up the BIOS is we want to come under F7, advanced mode. Under advanced mode, we'll go under settings, and then we'll go under save and exit. What we want to do is restore defaults, or if you have the option, load optimized defaults. And there we go, load optimized defaults. So I clicked on restore defaults, and then I hit yes. And now that we flashed the BIOS and we loaded optimal defaults, which could be in a few different places depending on your system, we'll come to the main setting. We'll enable game boost for my particular system. We'll enable AEXMP. It depends what XMP profile you'd like to use, or if your RAM comes with Expo profiles. Mine comes with XMPs, even though I'm on AMD. So now we'll click settings, and I'm just going to set some defaults on my system. They're going to be different on your system, surely. Time and date is correct. Okay, then we ignore VGA detection since we're not using onboard VGA. Graphics, we'll disable the integrated UMA auto since we're using discrete graphics. We want to make sure that Windows Boot Manager is our boot option number one. That's our Windows install. If we're using UEFI and GPT, okay, OC. Now here is where you would find your AXMP profiles, aside from clicking up here. Since we enabled XMP, that goes ahead and sets the speed of our RAM and then the cache, RAS, and TRAS latencies, as well as the voltages. You don't need to set anything else down over here, though I will enable context restore. That way we don't have to retrain the RAM every time our system restarts, which takes forever. Just the defaults here. We don't need to set anything additional. And then hit F10 to save and exit. And then we'll hit yes. All right, so now we're back in Windows. We'll open up HW Info. And we can see BIOS date is 1022 and the version is 191. So we are completely updated. Now you also want to make sure, now that we've updated the BIOS, there's been a ton of adjustive fixes as well. We want to get on the latest chipset version as well. So let's download that and install it real quick. So here we'll go back into Chrome or whatever browser, and we'll go to amd.com. Now, depending on your chipset, I have the X670E. We're going to go under resources and support, drivers, and scroll down a tiny bit. Here we're gonna select chipset. Then we're going to select AM5, since I'm using a socket AM5 CPU, the 7950, and I'm using the X670E chipset, and then I click submit. Then I select my operating system. I'm using 1164-bit. I could see here the latest chipset was 1021. I know that I used an older one, so that's even better. So now I just click download. Once that's done downloading, I just click on it here, AMD chipset software. Since it is the EXE alone, I could close out of this and all of this. And then just leave everything selected here, or if there's something without a check, place a check in there, then click install. Now this should only take a few minutes, and during this time, your system might turn the screen on and off. Don't worry, that's normal too. And now when this is done, we have two options, close and restart. I highly recommend you click close and then you manually right click on the start button, shut down or sign out, and restart. The reason I say to do that is, at times when you click restart, the AMD chipset installation utility is doing things in the background and you might miss that. So it's safer to just click close. Then some things are going to finish off in the background. Then you have the ability to manually reset your computer. You should always reset your computer when it asks you to. All right, so now we are on the very latest BIOS. Now we have the ability to take advantage of all of the DRAM, SSD, M.2 SSD, graphics update, security updates, performance updates, and all the updates that every single BIOS in between provides. Now you do need to make sure that if between any one of those updates, so let's say F1 all the way up to F51, just throwing out numbers there, if in between one of those, it tells you you need to flash this BIOS first before you go up to this BIOS, pay close attention to that, because if not, it may not work. So if you're at BIOS version F8, look at F9, F10, F12 says I need to flash this first before I get to the latest BIOS. After you flash F12, go back in the system, download F51, and then flash to F51 or the latest BIOS. Just make sure you do your homework. Look at every single BIOS release that's out there, what version you're on, all the way through, to make sure that you're 100% safe. So in this video, I've shown you how to update your BIOS. On top of that, I've shown you how to find out what motherboard you're using, then how to find the support site for your motherboard, how to find your BIOS, and then how to tell what version you're on, and then everything in between to see all it updates and all the features it provides. Next, we flash your BIOS, then we optimize your BIOS defaults, and then we set some basics within the BIOS. Then we downloaded the latest chipset driver and installed the latest chipset driver, all to get you all the performance you need out of your system and get rid of any potential blue screens you might have. So this is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou, showing you how to flash your BIOS. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou up. See you guys.